Hi everyone, Alfred here from Alfred.tv. I still can't do this opening without cracking up because it's just so stupid. Anyway, I'm here for yet another unboxing and a serious and granular product review. Let me show you what I'm unboxing that's been rotten in the box since like December. Yes, it's the Women's Health and / Men's Health Cardio Stepper. And this thing was on sale and I snagged it from Amazon.communist. I don't remember what the hell the price was, but whatever. Got a pretty decent review. So let's take this freaking thing out of the box. And don't fall. Well, I did use the official Alfred.tv shiv and the box is open after cutting off those restraining strap-ons. And this is what I'm dealing with. So I got to figure out, I guess I'm gonna tilt the box sideways and slide this crap out. So phase one is done, and from what I feel so far, the build quality is pretty good. It did come with a jump rope. Yeah, like I'm gonna use that, yeah, sure. And there is a product manual, and I guess there's a little bit of minimal assembly, so I will take a cursory look. And of course, my definition of giving something a cursory look is looking at it and then cursing. Puck Hugh. I said Puck, P-U-K, knock it off. Overall, packaging shrapnel is not too bad. I'll certainly cut this stuff up and throw it down into the dumpster. D-U-M-P-S-T-A-H, spelled the way I say it. Okay, so with the paperwork, or the manual, as I like to say, the manual, the manuel, we have, they pitch a My Cloud Fatness service, a premium, $15 a month. Yeah, sure, not gonna do it. We also have a stop. Please do not return this product to the store, all right? So, since I already discarded the box, Superman, since I already discarded the box, if this thing winds out to be a piece of shit or it breaks, I'm throwing it out into the dumpster. And while this product had the branding of Men's Health and Women's Health magazine, the manufacturer is indeed Paradigm Health and Swellness in Angelic Avenue in City of Industry, California. Really good cinematography, right? Added off angle. Yeah, those are the ones that make this. I don't know if it's manufactured here or in China, but whatever. All right, so it's from Paradigm Health and Wellness. Swellness. Oh, wow. Looking at the manual, that wasn't a jump rope. Good thing I didn't throw it out. These get attached to the device, I guess, so you can work your upper area while you're doing your thing. I like this warning. Air cylinders may become hot during use. That would be like a really good metric to see how hot you can get this freaking thing. Cook an egg. You see, I really should have opened the video with this page saying, holy shit, look at the assembly instructions. Jesus H. Christ. Listen, after seeing that page, if this thing malfunctions, yeah, I'm gonna throw it out. I'm looking at the safety instructions. Be sure all the screws, nuts, and bolts are tight. I assume they are. Before using the equipment, we recommend doing warm-ups. Nay, nay. I like this one. Only one person should be using the equipment at a time. Yeah, let's use this for, like, you know, group fitness. CrossFit. CrossFat. Orange fatness. Yeah, two people, one foot on each pedal. No, doesn't work like that. All right, number four is a really good one. Never operate this stepper if it's not working properly.
If it's not working properly, how can I freaking operate it?
Always use this equipment on a clear and level surface. Okay, so there goes my incline. For household use only, I'm in a condo, I guess I can't use it. Do not use outdoors or near water.
It said do not operate near water. Does that mean I can't have my hydration bottle next to it?
Use this product only for its intended use. What else could you use it for? Do not wear loose clothing. Never drop or insert an object. You feel faint, lightheaded, dizziness while operating the equipment. Stop exercising immediately. Yeah, no, I'm going to fall off the freaking thing. My Apple Watch is going to say you fell, and then it's going to call 911. All right, whatever. I'm spending way too much time on the safety stuff.
Well, here's a really important one. The maximum weight capacity for this product is 250 pounds. Do not exceed maximum weight capacity.
So if you are indeed an FF class individual, this product is a nay-nay.
Well, it didn't say it in the manual, but obviously I gotta, like, cut those straps, so that's next.
Okay, so speaking seriously for a brief moment, there is some minimal instructions and assembly instructions. It doesn't look like really that big a deal, so I'm gonna do that now.
Okay, so the steps so far, no pun intended, as in step. You lift up one of the legs, take a piss, lift up a leg, then you screw this thing in. This is some type of a maximum height adjustment. You connect what I thought was a free jumping rope. No, it's whatever. Connect that, and then this console, you pull, this thing pulls out. There is a tethered cable. Slap in two AAA batteries, but make sure you do what I did with regard to the battery, is to drop it down in there and then play the game of operation and try to get it out. No, I wound up tipping the thing upside down to get the battery out. It was very frustrating, but I was trying to get it out like the game operation. I was unsuccessful.
And yes, when I dropped that battery down there, I was very, very angry. I said berry.
Actually, this device is pretty cool. It does have a Bluetooth connectability so it can upload data to their My Cloud Fitness app, whatever. I mean, nice feature if you're going to use that.
All right, so I got it adjusted. Let's try not to fall. Let's try not to drop the camera. Overall, I'm pretty impressed. I'm about 167 pounds, and it's pretty smooth. The up-down motion, pretty smooth, pretty quiet. This is certainly definitely something to augment my routine outside and at LA Fitness when I want to do a quick workout at home, to help me with my freaking knees that are kind of hurting. But this is good. I give this a total thumbs up. So there you go. Alfred.tv granular unboxing and review. Let me stop this before I freaking fall. So for an in-home gym piece of equipment, the build quality, pretty good. I mean, does it replace the, you know, the pro gym gear? Nay, nay. But not bad. I think I paid $150 for it. I think it's normally $200. So I can understand why Men's Health and Women's Health put their brand name on it, because the product overall is pretty decent. So we'll see how it is, you know, over time. But like I said, for what it is and the price, to augment outdoor activities and gym activities, I give it a thumbs up. So there you go. Serious and granular unboxing and review from Alfred.tv. More to come. Mordecai. More to come. Stay tuned. Nice. And when you want to talk about build quality, solid as fuck.
Welcome to Alfred.tv.